Good evening. Welcome to Bethlehem University and Benson Great Hall. My name is Kevin Scholl. I work in the Music and Performing Arts Department, and I am privileged to work with a wonderful collection of amazing scholar artists who are dedicated to guiding and educating these student musicians, of which you'll see a wonderful group and example tonight. We thank you being here for the Bethel Choir Spring Concert. The Bethel Choir is actually traveling on a tour at the end of the school year. They're headed down to New Orleans, Memphis, and Nashville. And this is kind of an early Bon Voyage concert in a way. So you get a little bit of preview for their trip that's going on there. We'd like to invite you to many concerts that are going on later this spring. Next week, or I should say April 5th, the Lucia Chorum and Royal Register Choirs are singing in the Great Hall. And then on April 12th, the Bethel Chamber Orchestra will be giving their home concert for a mini tour they're taking to Illinois. Starting April 18th and running through the 28th, our Black Box Theater will be host to our spring play, a delightful murder mystery entitled The Plot Like Gravy Thickens. Yes, you're going to want to come. It's a play by Billy St. John and directed by Summer Scott. The play has been described as a murder mystery comedy with audience interaction, great storm effects, spiffy costumes, and lots of other good stuff. So we hope you'll come visit for that performance. We'd especially like to invite you to come to our culminating departmental concert on Friday, May 10th. Our Classics in the Great Hall performance. It will feature the Bethel Wind Symphony under the direction of Dr. Stephen Thompson. Our three concerto aria contest winners this year, two vocalists that are in this choir tonight, and a flautist from the Bethel Wind Symphony. On the back of your program, you'll see a QR code down on the bottom right that says our season brochure on it, and there you can scan in and see our departmental events webpage and descriptions of all of our concert there. And tickets for all of our events are for sale at tickets.bethel.edu. There's another QR code on the back of that program, and if you'd like to support us monetarily, which we would love and covet your support for our music students in our department, you could do so there as well. But especially tonight and in the days ahead, we're just grateful for you supporting these students and their performances. The psalmist sings in Psalm 96, "Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, praise his name. Proclaim his salvation day after day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous deeds among all peoples. For great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods." If you'd join me in prayer before we begin our performance tonight. Father, you are great and most worthy of praise. And tonight we lift up your name as we sing. We will sing new songs. We will sing songs from around the earth. We will sing songs to praise your name. And we pray that you would be glorified in all of our music making. And may these people here tonight who are listening be encouraged by these songs. And we pray that you would grant the choir faithfulness, skill, joy, and focus as they now sing. And may their offering be a sweet aroma to you, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Enjoy the evening.
sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow. That's the reason why I sing.
Psalms 104 and 33 says, I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. The Bible is full of song. We sing during times of sorrow, joy, love, and grief. We sing to connect with our own hearts as well as to heal the hearts of others. This concert will illuminate the reasons why we sing. Our first selection is one of heartbreak and sorrow. Grief first in love and then in loss of life. Although songs of grief and loss are arguably the most dreaded of the songs and tough on our ears and propel from our voices, it is also the most universal. Isaiah 23 and 16 says, O woman, you are forgotten. Take your harp and walk through the city. Play your harp well. Sing your song often, then people will remember you.
Thank you.
59 and 16 says, "But I will sing of your strength in the morning. I will sing of your love, for you are my fortress, my refuge in times of trouble. For how can I keep from singing? Our soloists will be Christiana Waller and Eric Jameson."
My life was on an endless song.
speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord. Love songs make up the soundtracks of our lives. When we are in church and feel overwhelmed by the love of Jesus, we sing. When rocking a small child to sleep, we sing. A favorite love song can become a husband and wife's first dance. We can rally toward love for our fellow man with songs of culture and nation. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. Colossians 3:16.
Oh, I now have the pleasure of introducing the assistant conductor, Miss Christiana Waller, who is a senior this year. Christiana has been phenomenal in just being capable of helping the section leaders and has spent 2 years as assistant conductor and is able to end her career here at Bethel with two definite acceptances to graduate school and one on the way, I'm positive. I'm sure she'll get in. So she's absolutely fabulous. So I'd like to welcome to the podium, Miss Christiana Waller.
Just to be a little annoying, it's my third year as assistant conductor. Yeah, it's been a little while. This next piece that we will be singing is called Öchtul. It's by Pert Usberg. The text is a poem by Ernst Enno. It is an Estonian piece that describes the evening, what happens in the dusk and the dusk as everybody goes to sleep, as the birds and the trees and just nature rests. And so part of why I picked this piece is I was searching for something that was meaningful to me. And with my Finnish heritage, the closest I could get to that chorally is Estonian. But it's really been such a joy to be in this position and to be able to work with the choir and make such awesome and cool sounds together. So without further ado, this is Öchtul by Pert Usberg, and I hope you enjoy.
Song of Solomon.
2:12. Flowers appear on the earth. The season of singing has come. The cooing of doves is heard in our land.
Oh, God, as I was born in one evening. 1 Corinthians 14, verse 15 says, "So what shall I do? I will pray with my spirit, but I will also pray with my understanding. I will sing with my spirit, but I will also sing with my understanding." Psalms are used to rally, to call to action, to boldly express beliefs. Psalms can proclaim truths with an emphasis that words alone cannot convey. Our final set includes songs that declare in dynamic utterance, first the need for boldness, second the intensity of repentance, and finally, how we are called to walk. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Psalm 95, verse 1. Exodus 15, verse 1 says, "Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. Both horse and driver he has hurled into the sea."
Oh,
Psalm 150, verses 1 through 6 say, "Praise the Lord. Praise God in the sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with a clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord."
At this time, we are going to do honors to our seniors. So when I call your name, if you could come down and grab a thank you. It is such a joy and a privilege to be able to work with these amazing young people. Their spirits, their energy, their intelligence, their compassion, how they work with each other. It is something that is a gift to me and to every person that they get to share the gift that God has given them with, the ability to be able to do this. So right now, I would like to call down the people who will not have another spring concert with us. So start with Ms. Emma Moen. Christiana Wall. Cindy Mitchell.
them.
But